Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I am going to explain about vectors, type and their characteristics. Vectors are small DNA molecule capable of self-replicating, cloning vehicle or a cloning DNA, carrier of DNA fragment. Example are plasmid, phage, hybrid vector and artificial chromosome. Now, what are the characteristics of vectors? As I already told, so they are self-replicating, they can form multiple copies. It consists of a replication origin site, cloning site, selectable marker genes, and usually they are small in size, low molecular weight, and it can be isolated easily and purified. It consists of control elements like promoter, operator, ribosome, binding site. These things are usually present in an expression vector. The origin of replication site will allow the vector as well as the foreign DNA to amplify in the host cell. Whereas the selectable markers are usually the antibiotic resistance genes like ampicillin resistance or tetracycline resistance genes. This allow the host to grow on a selective media where this antibiotics are added, like either it could be ampicillin or a tetracycline antibodies will be added and can selectively amplify these specific vector in the host cells. So transformants which are having this antibiotic resistant genes in the plasmid could able to survive in that selective medium. Then there will be a cloning, multiple cloning site which allow insert of foreign DNA to be inserted into the vector. Types of vectors. There are two types. One is cloning vector, another one is expression vector. In case of a cloning vector, it is used for the propagation or cloning of DNA insert inside a suitable host cell. Where an example for this cloning vector are plasmid, phage, phagemid, cosmid, phosmid, BAC or YAX. So here millions of copies of the DNA insert will be seen. Whereas in case of expression vector, the expression of DNA insert producing a specific protein will be seen. So this is the difference. Here in case of cloning vector, DNA will be amplified, whereas in case of expression vector, the inserted DNA will produce a specific protein. So it is used in case of expression of the DNA insert producing a specific protein. So this is the difference between expression vector and a cloning vector. And these cloning vectors are used in case of genomic library, preparing probes and genetic engineering experiments. Now, selection of cloning vector depends on the objective of cloning experiment, ease of working, knowledge existing about the vector, suitability and reliability. In case of expression vector, they have a eukaryotic promoter, which is the difference between the cloning vector and the expression vector, that they have a prokaryotic promoter, ribosome binding site, because it mainly focus on producing a specific protein where the expression of the protein will be takes place. So it consists of a ribosome binding site. Origin of replication will be there, antibiotic resistant genes, these are seen in case of cloning vector also. So inducible expression vector or eukaryotic expression vector, there are different types are there, so that we will discuss later. Coming to the plasmid or replicon, which are stably inherited in an extra chromosomal state. Most exist in a double stranded circular DNA molecule. If both the strand of the DNA are intact circle, the molecule are called covalently closed circle or CCC DNA. If one strand is intact, then the molecule are called open circle or OC DNA. When isolated from the cells, these CC have a deficiency of turns in the double helix called supercoiled configuration. because of their different structural configuration, supercoiled and OC, that is open circle DNA, separate on electrophoresis in agarose gel. In addition of intercalating agents such as ethylene bromide to supercoiled DNA, cause the plasmid to unwind. If excess ethylene bromide is added, the plasmid will rewind in opposite direction. There are three types of plasmid. One is fertile plasmid, contain gene for the formation of specialized pilus that initiate the formation of conjugation bridge between two cells for the purpose of transferring genetic material. So they can perform a conjugation. In case of resistance plasmid, they contain genes that build resistance against antibiotics or the poison. Next is the colplasmid. This is the third one, which contain genes that code for proteins, that is colicin, a bacteriocin, thus defend the host bacterium that can kill bacteria. Some of the examples of plasmid vector are PBR32, PBR27, and PUC8, PUC9, PGM3Z. Cloning vectors like PBR322, copy number of this plasmid will be 15 copies. Reconstructed plasmid, it is a reconstructed plasmid derived from E. coli plasmid called E1, and here the PBR represent, now this PBR322 plasmid consists of 4361 base pair. P denote plasmid, B is the scientific scientist called Bolivar, R for the Rodrigues. Number 322 is the number given to distinguish, and it is ampicillin resistance gene derived from RSF2124, and then tetracycline resistant gene was derived from PSC101, origin of replication from PMB1. Two selectable markers like ampicillin and tetracycline are present. This is the structure of E. coli plasmid cloning vector PBR322. PBR327. This plasmid is an expression plasmid. It is derived from a plasmid called PBR322. It consists of ampicillin and tetracycline resistance genes. Deletion of nucleotide between 1427 and 2516 nucleotide made this bacteria from PBR322. Then it has a high copy number than PBR322, that is 30 to 40 copy per E. coli cell. Thus, more copies of cloned genes, more will be the effect of cloned genes on the host cell was detectable. Deletion destroy the conjugative ability of the vector, which is important for the biological containment. PUC19 cloning vector. This was derived from PBR32. Usually, this PBR322 required double screening. PBR322 has a limited number of restriction sites. For this reason, PUC19 was engineered. PUC8 vector, which is a popular E. coli cloning vector derived from PBR322. Two parts derived from PBR322 are ampicillin resistance genes and call E1 origin of replication. Now, this vector consists of 2686 base pair. The nucleotide sequence of ampicillin resistance gene has been changed so that it no longer contain a unique restriction site. All these cloning sites are now clustered in the short segment of LacZ gene. LacZ gene was derived from E. coli. Polylinker sequence have a unique restriction site lies in the LacZ region. Clustering of restriction site allow the DNA fragment with two different sticky end to be cloned without restoring to additional manipulation. PUC18 and PUC19 is the vector having different combination of restriction site and provide greater flexibility for DNA to be cloned. Restriction site clusters in these vectors are the same as clusters in M13MP series of vectors. Thus, DNA cloned in PUC vectors can be transferred directly to its M13MP counterpart, enabling the cloned gene to be obtained as a single-stranded DNA. Next major advancement in plasmid is the inclusion of polylinker into the plasmid vectors. Polylinker is a tandem array of restriction endonuclease site in a very short span of DNA. For example, in case of PUC18, polylinker site consists of 13 restriction enzyme sites. 30 restriction enzyme sites are present. Regions span the equivalent of 20 amino acid or nucleotides, 60 nucleotides. Now, what are the advantages of polylinkers? They are unique site usually. Insert excision facilitated restriction endonuclease mapping and subcloning made easier. Directional cloning was done through this. Blue and white screening. Here, the plasmid DNA and the foreign DNA are both cut with the same restriction enzyme. Foreign DNA is inserted into the plasmid where it inactivates the LACZ gene. The recombinant plasmid is introduced into the bacterium, which become amphicillin resistant. All treated bacteria are spread on a nutrient agar plate containing amphicillin and beta galactosidase substrate and incubated for a period of time. And after a period of time, white colonies appeared must contain a foreign DNA. That means the transformants will produce a white colony, whereas the non-transformant will be in a blue color, will be seen as a blue color colonies. In case of blue and white screening of PUC18, the colonies with recombinant plasmid are white colonies. Will produce a white colony, and the colony with non-recombinant plasmid produce a blue colonies. The resistance to amphicillin has a amphicillin-resistant genes, is mainly due to amphicillin-resistant genes, contain portion of a lac operon which code for beta-galactosidase. Now, the gene of in our interest was inserted into the lac operon where the X-gal is the substrate for the beta-galactosidase and turn blue in the presence of functional beta-galactosidase, which is added into the medium. Insertion of foreign DNA into the beta-galactosidase becomes the polylinker disrupt. This led to the disruption of the polylinker, or lac operon. A non-functional and colonies fail to turn blue but appear white. So the transformant will produce a white colony, whereas the non-transformant will produce a blue colony. Now, what are the advantages of PUC vector over PBR322? One is the single step screening, and it consists of a cloning site, increases the number of potential cloning strategy available. So these are the advantages of PUC over a PBR322. PGM3Z, it is very similar to PUC vector and is of same size around and is of same size of 2750 base pair. It carries amphicillin resistance and LACZ gene. The cluster of restriction site is present in the LACZ gene. It has a two promoter sequence. One is T7 promoter, which is from the RNA polymerase of T7 bacteriophage, and SP6 promoter sequence, which produce RNA polymerase of SP6 phage that lie on either side of the cluster of restriction site. These promoters act as a site for attachment of RNA polymerase. Thus, if recombinant PGEM3Z is mixed with RNA polymerase in a test tube, transcription occur and RNA copies of the cloned fragment are synthesized. Bacteriophage. These are virus that specifically infect bacteria and during infection inject the phage DNA into the host cell where it undergo replication. The phage are simple structure and consists of DNA molecule having several genes for phage replication, which is surrounded by a capsid made up of protein. Types of phages. On the basis of structure, that is head and tail phage, example lambda phage, filamentous phage, example is M13. On the basis of phage infection cycle, lytic phase, the infection cycle is completed very quickly and release the new phage particle is associated with lysis of the host cell, that is called as a lytic phage. In case of lysogenic phage, the phage DNA get integrated into the bacterial DNA known as prophage, and after many cell division released by the lysis of the host cell, example lambda phage. Some phage do not form prophase, and the new phage particle are continuously assembled and released from the host cell without lysis of the host cell, example is M13 phage. Lambda phage, it is 49 kb in size. It is used as a cloning vector because the gene related in terms of function of clustered together in the genome and allow the gene to be switched on and off as a group rather than individual. The linear double-stranded DNA molecule has a stretch of 12 nucleotide at its either end, which act as a sticky end or cohesive end, which is also called as cos site. They can base pair to form a circular DNA molecule, which is important for insertion of bacterial genome. Another role of cos site is in the formation of large number of lambda DNA molecule for rolling circle mechanism of replication, which is also called as concatenine. Lambda phage cloning vector. The head and tail phage, very well studied, large and linear genome with 49 kb, lifestyle mode of lytic and which is a reproductive mode, and lysogenic, which is a latent mode. It has a large genome size of 49 kb and only 3 kb new DNA can be inserted, because if the size of the molecule is more than 52 kb, then it cannot be packaged into the head of the phage. This phage has more than one recognition sequence for almost all the restriction endonuclease. So the use of any restriction enzyme will break the phage DNA into number of small fragment. Despite these disadvantages, lambda phage is used for cloning large DNA, that is 5 kb to 25 kb molecules. Now, what are the advantages of lambda phage vector? As I told, the genome size is like 48,502, base pair height, transformation efficiency 1000 times more efficient than the plasmid vector. It consists of origin of replication genome, linear in head, single stranded protruding cohesive cos end of 12 base pair cos site, a site of cleavage of phage DNA. M13 phage. It is 6,407 nucleotide in length, circular, consists of a single stranded DNA molecule, and it is used as a cloning vector because it is less than 10 kb in size. The double stranded replicative form of the genome act like a plasmid. Gene cloned can be obtained in the form of a single stranded DNA which is helpful in gene sequencing and in vitro mutagenesis. It is easily prepared from the culture of infected E. coli cell. Single-stranded circular genome of 6.4 kb infect only F plus bacterium using Pylus F coded. Then can clone piece of DNA up to 6x the M13 genome size of 36 kb, but the larger the DNA, less stable clone is. Drawback is foreign DNA can be unstable, show slow down host cell growth, so deletion confer selective advantages. M13 phage cloning vector. M13 genome has 6.4 kb in length, consists of 10 closely packed genes for replication of the phage. There are single 507 nucleotide intergenic sequence and into which the new DNA can be inserted. This region is called as origin. Useful for sequencing, site-directed mutagenesis, any other technique that requires single-stranded DNA. M13 does not lyse cell, but it does slow them down. So it will form a LAN of E. coli. The M13 infection form a plaque, but they are turbid. M13MP1. The laxate gene was introduced in the IS and it does not have any unique restriction site in the genome. M13MP2, this vector was constructed by including the E. coli R1 site in the laxate gene. This was done by single nucleotide change in GGATTC near the start of laxate gene to GAATTC by in vitro mutagenesis. The beta galactosidase enzyme remained functional in the vector. M13MP7, it was formed by the inserting a polylinker into ECOR1 site of laxate gene of M13MP2. A polylinker is a short nucleotide sequence that consists of number of restriction site like ECOR1, BAMH1, SAL1, PST1 and has ECOR1 sticky end. These polylinkers does not disrupt the function of laxate gene. Now this is the structure of a M13MP, which consists of a polylinker gene or polylinker site in the laxate region. Now, what are the advantages and disadvantages of bacteriophage vectors? It is useful. Advantages are like it is useful for cloning large DNA fragment up to 10 to 23 kb, inherent size selection for large insert. Disadvantage is less easy to handle. Uses of bacteriophage like lambda phage cloning vector, like for gene cloning of large DNA fragment in eukaryotic genes, excellent selection capability, that is stuff means the insertion, DNA of our interest will be inserted, no, that fragment. Then clone lots of precisely sized DNA fragment for library construction. M13 based cloning vector. They are single-stranded DNA sequencing. It is also used for sequencing site-directed mutagenesis. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of bacteriophage vectors. Hybrid vectors. Component. It consists of component of both plasmid and a phage chromosome. Helper phage provided. Here it consists of a helper phage developed in 1978 by Barbara Horn and John Collins. It consists of 30 to 40 kb base pair of nucleotides and then origin of replication, cloning site, marker genes, DNA and cos site smaller than a plasmid. It is used for construction of genomic libraries of eukaryotes. Example is cosmid. Cosmid is a plasmid containing one or two copies of cos site of bacteriophage lambda. It is useful as a vector for gene cloning in conjugation with packaging system. The concatemers of cosmid molecule linked at their cos site act as a substrate for in vitro packaging. The host containing cosmid do not form plaques but form a colonies. Cosmid have insert capacity, high insert capacity, that is about 30 to 45 kb. They are often used as a cloning vector in genetic engineering. Cosmid can be used to build genomic libraries. They were first discovered by Collins and Horns in 1978. Cosmid can contain 37 to 52 normally 45 kb of DNA limits based on the normal bacteriophage packaging size. They can replicate as plasmid if they have a suitable origin of replication. For example, SV40 origin of origin site in mammalian cell line and COL-E1 origin for double-stranded DNA replication and F1 origin site for the single-stranded DNA replication in prokaryotes. They frequently also contain a gene for selection such as antibiotic resistance so that the transformed cells can be identified by plating on medium containing antibiotics. Those cells which did not take up the cosmid would be unable to grow. Unlike plasmid, they can also be packaged in phage capsid, which allow the foreign gene to be transformed into or between the cells of transduction. Plasmid become unstable after certain amount of DNA has been inserted into them because their increased size is more conducive to recombination. To circumvent this, phage transduction is used instead. This method possible by cohesive end, also known as cos site. In this way, they are similar to using the lambda phage as a vector. Except all the lambda phage genes have been deleted with the exception of cos sequence. Now there are two types of cosmid. One is single cos cosmid. Example is PGB8, which consists of a single cos site. Another one is dual cos cosmid, which consists of two cos site. Along with it, it has a cos recognition sequence on both the cos sites. Example are C2XB or super cos 1. PLFR5. In case of supercos1 is a novel 7.9 kb cosmid vector that contain bacteriophage promoter and promoter sequence flanking in a unique cloning site. This structure allow rapid synthesis of walking probe specific for extreme end of insert DNA. The cos1 vector is also engineered to contain genes for the amplification and expression of cosmid clones in eukaryotes. Cloning capacity of 30 to 42 kb. For generating cosmid library, it can be used for generating cosmid library. Ideal for high resolution restriction mapping and rapid chromosomal walking. In case of a PGB8, which is a single cosmid, is a circular plasmid, do not occur naturally. Origin of replication sequence for E. coli is present. selectable marker like ampicillin resistance and restriction site for the cloning of gene of our interest is also present in this vector. It contain phage lambda cos site which permit package into lambda phage head and therefore introduce to E. coli cells. Packaging only occur with 37 to 72 kb fragment, selection for large fragment. Packaged DNA is inserted into cell and then replicated as a very large plasmid. Advantages of cosmids: can be used in gene cloning vector. Cosmid are high insert capacity vector and they are used for the analysis of complex genome. Large gene can be studied intact and genetic linkage study can be carried out at molecular level. Background molecule which do not have their insert DNA or have a smaller insert are eliminated during packaging. Transformation frequency of cosmid is high. Phosmid, it is based on E. coli bacterial F plasmid, can insert 40 kb fragment of DNA. Low copy number in the host, that is one phosmid. Phosmid offer higher stability than comparable high copy number of cosmid. Contain other features similar to plasmid and or cosmid, such as origin of sequence and polylinkers. Phagmid vectors. Phagmid is a filamentous phage derived vector containing the replication origin of the plasmid. Properties are: it is small in size, it has a high genetic stability, it can be used to clone single or double stranded DNA. Phagmid or phasmid, the phage particle containing single stranded DNA are released from the bacterial host cell in the extracellular environment. The filamentous phage retard bacterial growth, but contrasting with the lambda phage and the T7 phage are not generally lytic. The helper phage are usually engineered to package less efficiently via defective phage origin of replication. Now, defective origin of replication, then the phagmid so that the resultant phage particle contain predominantly phagmid DNA. The F1 filamentous phage infection require a presence of pilus. So only bacterial host containing the F plasmid or its derivatives can be used to generate phage particles. Phagmid contain origin of replication, two origin of replication, phasmid or phage. This process is called DNA rescue. Replicate like a M13 producing single stranded DNA packaged and released in the presence of a helper phage. Whereas replicate like a phasmid producing double stranded plasmid DNA which has conventional property. So this phasmid can be used in sequencing work, can be done directly without subcloning from the phasmid to phage. East artificial chromosome vector is also called as a YAC vector. Host of this vector is a yeast. It consists of a centromere site, telomere site, along with the origin of replication site and a selectable marker and multiple cloning site. Yeast artificial chromosome is a human engineered DNA molecule used to clone DNA sequence in yeast cells. It is also called as a YAC, and YAC is an artificially constructed chromosome that contain centromere, telomere region for the maintenance and stabilization and protect the end from degradation happened by the enzymes. It consists of an autonomous replicating sequence also called as a ARS. This element is required for the replication and preservation of YAC in the yeast cells. ARS elements are thought to act as replication origin. Now, in case of YAC3, it consists of 11,400 base pair and it has a SUP4 gene, a suppressor tRNA gene, which overcome the effect of ADE2 arch mutation and restore wild type activity, resulting in colorless colonies. The host cell are also designed to have received TRP1 and URA3 alleles, which are complemented by the corresponding TRP1 and URA3 allele in the vector, providing a selection system for identifying the cell containing YAC vector, useful for cloning very large DNA segment or the fragment up to 500 kb, useful for very large DNA fragments. Now, this yeast artificial chromosome or vector is a linear plasmid vector, clone large DNA segment up to 100 to 1400 kb, occurring in two forms, circular and linear. Circular, which grow in bacteria, whereas the linear form multiplies in the yeast cell. PAYAC3 is the first YAC developed. It contain ARS sequence for replication, SENT1 sequence for centromeric function. TRP1 and URA3 are two selectable markers, and it is used for mapping complex eukaryotic chromosomes. Now, how to construct yeast artificial chromosome vector? First, the YAC is built using initial circular plasmid, typically broken into two linear molecule using restriction enzyme. DNA ligase is used to ligate a sequence or a gene of interest between the two linear molecules, forming a single large linear piece of DNA. Yeast artificial chromosome are special linear DNA vector that resemble normal yeast chromosome. YAC contain telomere that stabilize the chromosome end and the centromere that ensure chromosome partitioning between two daughter cell and a selective marker. YAC vector can carry thousands, hundreds of thousands of base pair of foreign DNA. Disadvantages of YAC: very fragile and prone to breakage, unstable with their foreign DNA insert often being deleted, loss of entire YAC during mitotic growth, difficult to separate the YAC from other host chromosome, the yield of DNA is not high, chimerism has been seen. Bacterial artificial chromosome vector is also called as BAC, is a DNA construct based on the functional fertility plasmid or F plasmid used for transforming and cloning in bacteria, usually E. coli. They are capable of carrying approximately up to 300 kb of insert DNA sequence. Now, the common gene component of BAC, it consists of a RepE site for the plasmid replication and regulation of copy number, and PAR-A and PAR-B for partitioning F plasmid DNA into daughter cells during division and ensure stable maintenance of the BAC. Selectable markers for the antibiotic resistance. Some BAC also have LAC-Z at the cloning site for blue or white screening or white selection. Then there will be a T7 or SP6 site which is a phage promoter for transcription of inserted gene, and there will be a origin S or origin for replication site. Now, the steps involved in molecular cloning of BAC vector. First, the cloning vector, that is the BAC vector as well as the foreign DNA, will be digested with the same restriction enzyme to get a sticky end in both the gene of our interest and the vector. then these gene of our interest will be inserted into the vector with the help of an enzyme T4 ligase. After inserting the gene of our interest into the back vector, this vector are transformed into bacterial cell and it will be allowed to amplified so we can get a multiple copies of back vectors. I mean, even along with the vector, we will get the gene of our interest is also going to be multiplied. Later, the screening will be done by screening the white and blue colonies. Now, the blue colonies having a plasmid without insert, that is, it is a non-transformant, whereas the white colony have a plasmid with the foreign gene of our interest. So, in this way, screening of the transformant will be done. Now, the application of BAC. BACs are being greatly used in modeling genetic diseases in order to study their effect in the experimentation of transgenic mice. BAC have been used to study neurological diseases such as Alzheimer's disease or in the case of Down syndrome. The genome of several large DNA viruses and RNA viruses have been cloned as BACs. These constructs are referred to as infectious clones. Now, the comparison between YAC and BAC system. Usually, the features are listed here. In case of YAC, the configuration of the DNA configuration is linear in case of YAC, whereas circular in BAC. Host for the yeast artificial chromosome is yeast, whereas bacterial artificial chromosome vector is bacteria. Copy number is 1. In case of BAC, it is 1 to 2. Cloning capacity is unlimited in case of YAC, whereas none to very low in case of a BAC. Chimerism is seen up to 40%, whereas chimerism is nil in BAC. Insert stability is unstable in YAC, whereas it is very stable in a BAC. So that's why it is more suitable. Usually, a settled vector are capable of replicating in two or more types of host. They can replicate autonomously or integrate into host genome and replicate when the host replicate. Commonly used for transporting gene from one organism to another, like from a eukaryote to a prokaryote, or animal transforming from animal to a plant cell. Prokaryotic vector cannot exist and work in eukaryotic cells because the system of two group of organism varies. Prokaryotes lack introns, while eukaryotes consists of introns. Therefore, vector with two origin of replication were constructed, which may exist in both prokaryotes as well as the eukaryotes. Hence, they are called as shuttle vector. One of the example is the glowing tobacco, which was produced by the insert of luciferase gene to the plasmid and transformed to the bacterium. This plasmid was grown in the agrobacterium amplified in the agrobacterium in large quantity, and it was transformed to infect the tobacco plant, which led to the glowing tobacco. Now, as I told, this vector can propagate in two different hosts. Usually, the prokaryotic host will be the E. coli, whereas the eukaryotic host species could be mammalian cell, insect cell, or yeast. Depending on this, different types of shuttle vectors are formed. E. coli and yeast shuttle vector, which is also called as YEP13 vector. Now, this YEP13 illustrates several general characteristic features of a yeast cloning vector. First, it is a shuttle vector, as well as it has a 2 micrometer origin of replication and a selectable LEU to gene, and this YEP13 also include the entire PBR322 sequence and can therefore replicate and be selected for both yeast and E. coli host. Since this vector can replicate in two different hosts, they have two origin of replication site. One is for the E. coli, like in this vector, one is for the E. coli where it will replicate in the E. coli host, whereas another one is SV40 which replicate in the phage. Depending on the vector, this origin of replication also varies. Now this SV40 origin site is from SV40 polyoma virus. Now this SV40 origin containing plasmid replicate in cells that are infected with SV40 polyoma virus express the large T antigen. HEK293 T cells. These cells are stably transfected with large T antigen expressing construct which was selected with G418 or genitisin. Episomal replication. DNA does not become diluted with cell division as quickly as non-replicating plasmid. Another example for E. coli yeast shuttle vector is YEP352, which is about 5181 base pair. It consists of a origin of a replication site for E. coli as well as another origin of replication, that is 2 micron origin replication for Saccharomyces cerevisiae. It consists of a lac promoter and URA3 promoter lac promoter, there is a multiple cloning site. Next is the E. coli mammalian shuttle vector. Most of them are DNA virus with a circular genome to which bacterial origin and selectable marker have been added. Example are adeno associated virus, adenovirus or baculovirus. Now, in case of E. coli and insect shuttle vector, example is the back-to-back vector. Here, the transform F. E. coli with a genome of viral DNA and even with a P. fast back and a helper plasmid. Now, this helper plasmid helps in transposition of the protein and after transfection with PFAST back1 and helper plasmid along with the recombinant virus into the E. coli, transposition of T7 element to mini at TN7 takes place, that is a transposable element, then which led to composite backmid. Later, isolation of the mixture of plasmid DNA and retransform E. coli will be done, which led to pure composite backmid. Then isolation of backmid DNA and transfect insect cells will lead to pure composite virus. So in this way, shuttle vector will be used in insect. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.